This will be a super easy step-by-step tutorial of how to install Home Assistant OS on a Raspberry Pi 5, where step 1 is to get the needed parts, which are Raspberry Pi 5 and a SD card. All Raspberry Pi 5 models with 2, 4 and 8 gigs of RAM are just fine for Home Assistant. Along with the Raspberry, you need a 27 watts USB-C power supply to power up the device. Try to get an original one if you don't want to have issues. A Raspberry Pi case is optional, but if you decide to buy one, make sure that it is having an active cooling. Next and final thing is a SD card. Any card bigger than 16 GB should be enough, but try to get at least 32 GB, and the faster SD card, the better. I will list some links in the video description to some recommended SD cards and Raspberry Pi 5 devices, their power supplies and good cases if you want to check their current prices. Step 2 is to download and install the Raspberry Pi Imager 2 from the Raspberry Pi website. The exact link can be found again in the video description, and this tool is available for all major operating systems, Linux, Windows, Linux and Mac. I'm using macOS here, but the look and feel is the same for all. Start the Raspberry Pi Imager, select Raspberry Pi 5 as device, click on Choose OS, find other specific purpose OS section, then look for the Home Assistant and Home Automation, select Home Assistant, and one more time Home Assistant. At the time of shooting this video, the latest Home Assistant OS version is 11.5 and it is in a preview state. But if you see a different version here, don't worry, just select it. After that, insert your SD card in your computer. You'll need a card reader or SD card slot for that part and click on Storage button. Then select your SD card, which will be entirely erased, and Home Assistant OS will be written on it in just several minutes. And here comes step 3. After writing of the Home Assistant OS on your SD card is finished, unplug the SD card from your computer and plug it in your Raspberry Pi 5. Connect your Raspberry to your home network with a LAN cable and connect the power supply so the device to start booting. Wait a minute or two, then try to open a browser from your computer or phone connected to the same network where your Raspberry Pi 5 is connected and type homeassistant.local:8123. If this doesn't work for some reason, for example if you have a running Home Assistant already, you should find the IP of your Raspberry Pi 5 device from your router interface, and you should use that IP instead of the above mentioned hostname. My Raspberry Pi 5 is having the following IP, 10.0.0.31. I will type that IP in my browser, then I'll type :8123 as a port, and here it is. I'm able to see a screen saying that installation of Home Assistant is in progress and I have to wait few minutes more. If you run into some issues at this point, make sure that your Raspberry Pi 5 is having an internet access, as it might need to download the latest Home Assistant images from the internet. After a while, you should see a welcome screen, which is the step 4 of our journey. Namely, this is the Home Assistant onboarding process. The first thing here that I want to mention is that you can select your language from this drop-down list. After that, you have two options: to restore from backup, which is great if you already have Home Assistant and you wish to move that existing installation to your new and shiny Raspberry Pi 5 device. If that's the case, just select Restore from Backup and select your full Home Assistant backup file from the dialog that will be shown. The other option is to start from scratch by clicking on the Create My Smart Home button. Doing so, you will be guided through few easy steps, where the first one is to enter a username and password for your Home Assistant. On the next screen, you can select your location and you can use the search field or the map or both. After that, you can decide whether to share anonymized information from your installation or not. You can open that link to learn more if that's needed. I'll share everything here as I have nothing to hide and I'm willing to help, but you may decide otherwise. On the next screen, Home Assistant will eventually find some compatible devices in your home, and this is just for your information only. It is not possible to set up and configure these devices at this point, but you can do that at later stage from the Home Assistant settings. And this is it! Home Assistant on Raspberry Pi 5 up and running! This is the main Home Assistant dashboard with the dark theme, but I personally prefer light theme and I'll change that by clicking on my username. More info can be found in my Home Assistant webinar, which is absolutely free. Thanks for watching, I'm Kirill and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!